Okay, to begin with, on the last end, we discussed about two methods which were mainly used for postural assessment of the risk involved due to the awkwardness in the posture. There are many factors which are responsible for stresses. As I have discussed in my first lecture that there are four main factors like force, frequency, posture, and environment, which are responsible for stresses on the workplace. So the last two methods were mainly related to the postural stress or the contribution due to the posture or awkward deviation. And before that, I have discussed two methods which can be used anywhere as a ready-to-use methods for quickly assessing about the perceived level of discomfort or perceived level of exertion or perceived level of point of discomfort. Now, moving further, because this posture is not the only factor responsible for the stresses, we may have other factors like force and frequency that those can play important role in creating fatigue. So starting from another method which I am taking part as a part of your curriculum is called as strain index. It was given by Gerg, who was professor in University of Michigan, and this method is basically based on the can be applied in the workplace is where task is repetitive in nature. Because as we learn, ergonomics is nothing but dealing to control repetitive strain injuries or repetitive motion injuries or work-related musculoskeletal disorders. So as we had done from the previous two methods, RULA and RIBA, we were mainly concerned about the posture. But here we are concerned about the task that is repetitive in nature. And when it is repetitive in nature, then two factors become more important: frequency of work. Sometimes we call it pace of work, or pace is a different thing than the frequency. Then frequency of work and the force level. So these two factors become prominent in those tasks. For example, I've shown you the video of punching, buffing, polishing, or assembling, where the repetitive work is done having a low force level but a high frequency level. So these tasks involve the risk of developing the injuries in wrist or forearm or the shoulder, which are nothing but as we call repetitive strain injury, repetitive motion injuries, or work-related, we call them repetitive strain injuries, or the synonym is work-related musculoskeletal disorders. Now, these are nothing but tendinitis, carpal tunnel syndrome. We have tennis elbow, etc. So there are many such type of injuries which are due to the uncontrolled frequency or due to the overexertion related to the frequency or the force. For that purpose, the strain index is a semi-quantitative job analysis method. It is semi-quantitative because it is giving you a index as the index we were getting in RULA and RIBA. Here it is called as strain index. And strain index with respect to the level of risk involved regarding repetitive strain injuries. Now, there are in this method they have considered calculating a strain index as a function of strain index as a function of six parameters or six variables. six variable. What are these six variable? We see over here: intensity of exertion, duration of exertion, effort per minute, hand rest posture, speed of work, duration of task per day. Now, what is the meaning of intensity of exertion? As I gave you the example, cutting a paper or cutting a sheet. So the intensity of exertion is more. You are hammering over the wood or you are hammering over the metal. Duration of exertion. In every task, you have a portion. For example, this is your clock. In the clock, at one particular moment, you start doing the task or pressing the task. For example, it is press. And after a while, your hand takes rest. So this is your duration of exertion, and this is your rest in that particular cycle. So what is the duration of exertion? What are the efforts per minute? So how many these efforts are over a minute? So these are efforts per minute, whether they are 4 efforts per minute or 5 efforts or 10. Generally in industry we find 10 to 20 for light work task or light repetitive task. Then we have a only in this method we are not giving any consideration for neck or shoulder or back or legs. We are only giving to the awkwardness or the normality of hand wrist system. So hand wrist, if it is in a normal position, as I told you, we generally consider the normal position is of the handshake, where hand remains parallel to the plane in which radial and ulnar bone lies, and it is parallel to our body plane. Body is divided into three planes. One is called as sagittal plane, which is dividing the body in two equal halves. Then we call it coronal plane, which divides the body into front and back. And then we call a lateral plane, in which body is supposed to be divided in upper and lower part. So about the sagittal plane, if the wrist is parallel, it is considered to be normal and without any deviation in it. So if there is no deviation or lesser deviation within the range of the comfort zone, then wrist is or hand is supposed to be in a comfortable position or in towards the extreme range of motion of the wrist and hand. Then speed of work, whether this effort you are starting the effort at particular point and your effort ends over here and then the rest period comes. So in this rest period there is no effort, but at what speed you are making an effort, whether it is an immediate effort or it is a slow paced effort, so that variable will be considered over here. Then we have duration of task per day. This is an overall consideration throughout the what we consider at 8 hour job. So in 8 hour job, how many hours you are involved in work and how many hours you are taking rest. So this rest is nothing but the rest of the cycle. But it is not actually a rest. You get some rest periods like lunch break, micro breaks for teas, etc. So that will be subtracted from this 8 hour job, and then we consider it duration of the task per day. So these were six basic factors on which we can obtain what is called as strain index. That is an indication of level of risk involved in repetitive tasks, These are very common in industry, and a very huge population of workers are involved in this kind of activity. Now, what GERC did, they made categories for each factor or each variable. Every variable you see here, either it is light or they have made a rating scale for every category, every variable. There were six variables: intensity of exertion, as I explained you, what do you mean, what is the meaning of intensity of exertion, then duration of cycle, that is percentage of cycle. So for example, every cycle is of 4 seconds, and only for 1 second we are putting our exertion or force or cutting force or punching force or gripping force, whatever it is, or pushing force. So this is percentage of duration within the cycle. Then efforts per minute, how many efforts a person has to do in a minute. Then the awkwardness of hand-wrist posture. Then speed of work. Then duration of work. So all these factors which we see over here, we have to find out in terms of rating of comfort or discomfort. So rating of comfort and discomfort is defined by this particular table. And this table helps us to make a decision whether the task was light or very hard, whether the duration of the cycle was less than for 10 seconds or more than for 50% of the time, efforts were 4 or efforts were 20, hand-wrist posture was done very good means it is in a neutral position. Neutral position means no rotation of forearm, no radial ulnar deviation, and no extension or flexion in the wrist. Then speed of work, whether your effort is very quick in nature or it is slow in nature. Then duration of involvement in the task throughout the day of 8 hours. So we are assuming all this analysis for a job of 8 hours work. So in this case, once you have ranked the ratings for each variable, each responsible variable for the strain index, we go for giving the weightage for each variable. And weightage for each variable is different. Weightage for intensity, weightage for duration, weightage for effort, weightage for wrist hand posture, weightage for the work, and weightage for the duration. But in general, the formula what they give is nothing but the strain index is a multiplication of the weightage of intensity of exertion multiplied by duration of exertion weightage into effort weightage, hand-wrist posture weightage, then speed of work weightage, and the duration per 8 hours weightage. But these weightages are defined by GERC with respect to their industrial survey, with respect to their research outcome. And what are these? We see here, these weightages we call as multipliers. And with respect to each rating, sorry, with respect to each rating from 1 to 5, we have a respective multiplier value regarding every variable. And those are presented in the next table, which see over here. Now, in this case, what you see with respect to intensity of exertion, if it is poor, it is low, then 1, very hard, then 9. So the factor we get for a strain index, sorry, suppose we have to calculate a strain index. So in case of a strain index, the task was very hard, so we will take 9 as a multiplier. When duration of exertion of cycle is suppose 10% of the cycle time, so we will go for 0.5. If efforts per minutes are 4 or less, then we will go for 0.5. If the posture is in neutral way or slightly awkward, then you can go for 1. Then if a speed of work is moderate, we can go for 1. If duration for 8 hours job, see here, I forget what. If duration of the work is between 2 to 4 hours, it is 0.75. So in this case, we are going to have a particular value of a strain index. That is an indication of risk of involved in repetitive tasks. And these tasks are only where the whole body posture is not playing very much role. Only the stresses are due to the repetitiveness of the work. For example, you are provided with a comfortable chair, you are provided with a comfortable workstation, but the task is very demanding. You are working on a paced assembly line. In a given time period, you have to complete the job so that the job can move on the conveyor forward to the next workstation, and there will be no or very less pileup of the at the buffer spaces between one workstation and the other workstation. So in those kind of demanding task, we have to apply this strain index as an evaluation parameter. So in this case, what strain index we are getting is 1.6875. So this is a particular value. Now Gerg has given a kind of criteria over here. If the value is, this is what is the formula we have already discussed, that is strain index score is nothing but the multiplication of the multipliers with respect to the level of difficulty regarding each variables from the respective tables, and then we get a final score. So here you are having final score 1.6785. So they say that the jobs, when they had obtained the scores for a large population, what they did was they correlated with respect to jobs which were creating problems or the jobs which were not creating problems. Based on that kind of understanding, they made a decision that if a score is below 4.5, then there is no risk of repetitive strain injuries. But if the score is more than 4.5, there is a risk of repetitive injury. So these data were basically obtained from industrial data, where they had a kind of survey where every job was job selected was analyzed and a score was calculated, and then the worker was examined for their level of injury. So the jobs which were having a score 4.5 to 81 were found with the some sort of WMSGs or some sort of RSI. But the jobs which were having a score 0.5 to 4.5 were not found with RSIs or WMSGs. Therefore, they finally gave a criteria that based on these results, the strain index score less than 5 is probably represented as safe job. So this was only one method which I am considering for the syllabus point of view. There is another method which is called as OKRA method or OWASP method, but we are not going to consider those methods over here. Now, I will give you some of the problems on this from the book of Bridger, which you can use for calculating the strain index or ruler or rebar also. Now, moving further in this work methods measurements,